Good morning. Thank you for coming along. I've been joined by the Acting Chief Health Officer, Professor Ben Cowie, to provide a daily update on where the COVID-19 pandemic is up to and a number of changes that we'll be bringing into place, particularly arising from the National Cabinet decisions yesterday. First, however, on vaccinations, more than 12% of Victorians 12 years and above are now had their three doses. And I want to thank all those Victorians who have come forward to get that third dose. It is so important, and as all the data shows, so critical in protecting people from the Omicron variant. 93% of Victorians 12 and above have had their first and second doses. Yesterday, 20,078 Victorians were vaccinated, and those numbers continue to grow since the state-run clinics, in partnership with primary care providers, ratcheted up the program once an extra million Victorians became eligible on Tuesday. So please, if you are due your vaccination for that third really important dose, contact your GP, contact your chemist, or contact one of the state vaccination hubs. It is just so important to get that third booster jab. It's the strongest intervention you can make to protect yourself from this growing chain of transmission right across our community. In regards to people with COVID-19 in Victoria yesterday, we see currently 631 Victorians in hospital. That's an increase of 40 from yesterday's figure. We have 100 people in intensive care. That is slightly down on the day before. And we have 22 Victorians currently on a ventilator. That is slightly up on the figure from yesterday. Very tragically, 6 further Victorians lost their life with COVID yesterday, and we take this opportunity to send our condolences to those families and loved ones. That must be a very sad time for all those involved, and we wish them our best thoughts and prayers. There were 21,997 people formally diagnosed through the PCR system yesterday with COVID-19. And that was from the figure of some 64,861 Victorians tested through that PCR system where the results came in yesterday. That's a infectivity rate of about a third and points to the huge pressures that the PCR system is having, and hence the kind of changes that were endorsed yesterday by National Cabinet around rapid antigen testing, and we'll come back to that in the very near future. What it is clear is that we are in a new phase of this pandemic and a new phase of how we need to respond. The strategies of the last 2 years have served us very well in regards to those earlier variants. We need and are indeed changing to a whole heap of other new approaches when it comes to how we respond to the Omicron variant. This has to be a system that responds to us as we now need to transform many, many aspects of how we manage the Omicron variant in this pandemic. One where technology such as rapid antigen testing is at the heart of that response. One that protects the PCR system for those who need it most, understanding that at the moment there are some really significant issues of access to both. That is why we are working through some of the changes that we will go through. Yesterday at National Cabinet, the Commonwealth, the states and the territories discussed how to make sure that this rapid antigen testing technology is at the heart of this Omicron variant response. And it's in that regard that Victoria had been doing some preparatory work in regards to the issue of how do we ensure those people who test positive on the rapid antigen tests are included in the public health and primary health care responses to get us through the challenges that we are seeing at the moment. That is why we've ordered, as the Acting Premier pointed out yesterday, some 44 million rapid antigen tests are due to come in and start to come in the coming weeks, with at least over 700,000 coming in very current time frames of the next day or so. And it's in that regard that the important issues of how rapid antigen testing is at the base of people self-reporting. Getting a positive rapid antigen test is important, and that's important for the individual, their close contacts, their family members, and indeed ultimately their workplaces and their education settings. But it's also important that we all in the healthcare system have access to that positive test as well. That's why today I will be signing pandemic orders that recognise people with a rapid antigen test as a probable case, as a new description in the pandemic orders. But what it will mean is essentially they will have precisely the same obligations and the same rights as someone, whether it be for clinical support, whether it be financial support from both the state or the Commonwealth, and a whole range of other opportunities to be part of that primary healthcare response to keep them safe as they work through their infectivity. Essentially, this new category, based on a rapid antigen test, will be the same in the system as if you were diagnosed through a PCR system. These orders will come into effect as of 11:59pm tonight, and Professor Cowie, as the Acting Chief Officer, will speak in more detail about how people who turn positive based on a rapid antigen test will have that information captured and shared. The goal is to make sure that we have less time at testing centres, and that as a result people focus more quickly on the thing that is most important, getting through that COVID infective period and getting better with the support you need as quickly as possible. We appreciate that at the moment, with the shortages of both rapid antigen testing and the difficulties that creates in accessing the PCR system, that there are transitional issues that the Prime Minister referred to in his public comments. We are committed to working through those as quickly and as safely as we possibly can. Also, from tonight, there will be further changes insofar as the density quotient arrangements apply in some areas of hospitality and entertainment. A density quotient of one person per 2 square metres will be in place for indoor entertainment and hospitality venues, which is a similar rule that has been in place in New South Wales since before the new year. The exception to this will be indoor seated cinemas and theatres, where because people are seated and masked, there are other factors at play that allow us to make this exception. We think this is a sensible change, particularly in the face of the continued huge growth in transmission, particularly amongst young people. Yesterday's formal figures, 40% of those cases were people in their 20s, and every indication is it's overwhelmingly from hospitality and related environments.